Now to a new dimension in urban planning, taking the personality of a community more deeply into account when making decisions about it. Our ABC transportation correspondent Gio Benitez joins us now with more. This is very, very interesting, Gio.
It really is, Amy. Hey there. In some communities, just getting from point A to point B is an incredibly difficult task. So right now, we're introducing you to a group of women who are hoping to make a big impact one road at a time.
In city after city, this is the new reality. Streets closed down to traffic, parking spots turned into outdoor dining. But for some, these changes are triggering a moment of reckoning. And Dr. Destiny Thomas is on the front lines.
So for you, that speed hump.
It represents so much. It's an act of atonement.
For Dr. Thomas, there's more to a road than meets the eye.
This speed hump suggests that someone took the time to go to every house on this block. It's a transportation feature that requires civic engagement in order to exist.
She runs a unique California firm from LA to Oakland, comprised solely of black women, the Thrivance Group, urban planners focused on how people of color move throughout American cities.
I am working in the interest of rooting out racism from every mode. I should be able to wake up and choose for myself how I want to get to where I'm going. And that shouldn't be the most stressful decision of my day. And right now, for a lot of people, it is.
She says the key to helping a community is by engaging directly with its residents, hearing their needs. For example, to many, adding a bike lane may seem like a big help.
In a community that hasn't seen any kind of commitment, investment, or anyone leaning into the overall well-being of the community, the bike lane is a telltale sign that cost of living is going up and that we're approaching displacement.
You don't want to change something so much that then other people come in and displace
exactly.
The residents.
And the way you avoid that is by bringing community along every step of the way and implementing it in a way that matches the values and cultural construct of the community.
Let them know what's good in the hood.
One of those members of the community, Keita Price in Oakland. She's worked with Dr. Thomas alongside many others to think outside the box, like this bike lane in the middle of the street.
It's an East Oakland culture for youth to ride in the middle of the street.
This is what it means to listen to members of the community, because here you didn't want the traditional bike lanes at the side of the road.
Right. We want to reflect the culture in a way and exactly how we ride.
And watch what happens right as we're talking about issues on the road. A car accident just feet away.
Did you get that?
Literally, we just saw an accident right now.
Yes.
That speaks to an issue with the streets, right?
Yeah, there's not many ways to make left and right turns, and there's only one lane, so it's just not how we naturally kind of drive in East Oakland, and so it's creating additional issues like that.
Greetings from Oakland, California.
In Oakland, Thrivance Group strategic planner Brittany Brown now finds herself trying to help the community she grew up in.
All we were talking about was biking and walking, and I was like, yeah, in theory, sure, let's bike and walk, but not everybody can do that. And not everybody can be a commuter. I think we tend to plan for people who have resources and then we expect everybody else to fall in line. And
why is that?
I can't really say anything else but racism. Seriously, I don't know what else to kind of attribute it to.
And these women feel now, perhaps more than ever, they have an opportunity to be truly heard. With the pandemic changing transportation as we've known it, and the Black Lives Matter movement putting a spotlight on these issues.
Now is not the time to judge why people choose to move and navigate space the way that they do. And if you live in a body that looks like mine, or if you are a trans black woman, or if you are a young black man, the odds are stacked against you no matter what mode you choose.
And Gio joins us now. We're glad you're okay after that near miss with that interview. But these women were so powerful and so incredible. I'm curious, how are officials reacting to their suggestions?
Well, Amy, I got to tell you, local officials in LA and Oakland, they are listening. In fact, several changes are underway. But Dr. Thomas says a lot more needs to be done, and she hopes this message spreads far beyond California to every city in America.
I think that's a hope we can all share, Gio. Thank you very much for that very incredible report. We appreciate it.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.